So let's look at the last quantity we haven't talked about so far, and that is the probability of the hypothesis. Well, just like the probability of D is the prior on the data, this is, in fact, your prior on the hypothesis. So just like the probability of D is a prior on the data, the probability of H is a prior on a particular hypothesis drawn from the hypothesis space. So in other words, it encapsulates our prior belief that one hypothesis is likely or unlikely compared to other hypotheses. So in fact, what's really neat about this from a sort of AI point of view is that the prior, as it's called, is in fact our domain knowledge. So in every algorithm that we've seen so far, everything that we've said, there's always some place where we stick in our domain knowledge, our prior belief about the way the world works, whether that's a similarity metric for KNN, or whether it's something about which features might be important, so we care about high information gain in decision trees, or our belief about the structure of a neural network. Those are prior beliefs. That represents domain knowledge. And here in Bayesian learning, here in this notion of Bayes' rule, all of our prior knowledge sits here in the probability, our prior probability over the hypotheses. Does that all make sense?
Yeah, it's really interesting, I guess. So we talked about things like kernels and similarity functions as ways of capturing this kind of domain knowledge. And I guess what it's saying is that it's maybe tending to prefer or assign higher probability to hypotheses that tend to group things a certain way.
Exactly right. So, in fact, when you use something like Euclidean distance in KNN, what you're saying is, well, points that are closer together ought to have similar labels, and so we would believe any hypothesis that puts points that are physically close to one another to have similar outputs, we would say are more likely than ones that put points that are very close together to have different outputs.
Neat.
So let me just mention one last thing before I give you a quiz, okay? So see if this makes sense. I'm going to see if you really understand Bayes' rule. So let's imagine that I wanted to know under what circumstances the probability of a hypothesis given the data goes up. What on the right side of the equation would you expect to change, go up or go down or stay the same, that would influence whether the probability of a hypothesis goes up?
So the probability of the hypothesis given the data, what could make that combined quantity go up? So one is looking at the right-hand side, the probability of the hypothesis. So if you have a hypothesis that has a higher prior, is more likely to be a good one before you see the data, then that would raise it after you see the data too.
Right.
And I guess the probability of the data given the hypothesis should go up. Oh, which is kind of like accuracy, right? It's kind of like saying that if you pick a hypothesis that does a better job of labeling the data, then also your probability of the hypothesis will go up.
Right. Anything else?
I guess the probability of the data going down, but that's not really a change from the hypothesis.
Right. But it is true that if this goes down, then the probability of the hypothesis given the data will go up. But as you point out, it's not connected to the hypothesis directly. I'll write an equation for you in just a moment that'll kind of make that, I think, a little bit clearer. Okay, but you got all this, right? So I think you understand it. So we got Bayes' rule, and notice what we've done. We've gone from this sort of general notion of saying we need to find the best hypothesis to actually coming up with an equation that sort of makes explicit what we mean by that. That what we care about is the probability of some hypothesis given the data. That's what we mean by best. And that can be further thought as the probability of us seeing some labels on some data, given hypothesis, times the probability of the hypothesis, even without any data whatsoever, normalized by the probability of the data. So let's play around with Bayes' rules a little bit and make certain that we all kind of get it. Okay?
Sure.
Okay.